Dear God, I realize that I've been quiet recently, and to be honest, I think I realize that you just aren't listening. For the last 20-odd years, I would ask you for help and guidance, wisdom, strength, patience, and of these you gave me none. I would seek answers in and from you, and I would receive none. I would knock on every door I could find in my darkness, and you opened none to shed light on my path or guide me to a new path. You told me that you would never leave me or forsake me, but I finally realized that you can't leave or forsake me. Not because you're omniscient, not because you promised, not because my mom and dad always told me that you would be there for me, not because I have relied on talking to you for most of my life, but because you exist only in my imagination. I know it's hard for you to imagine me leaving you. I know it must feel as though I'm rejecting you, and that there is something you can do to make me want to be with you again. But honestly, you are harmful to me and to those that I love. This is the one time that I can honestly and truthfully say, it's you, not me. I've seen you infect the lives of my family, leading to a mother that lives her life waiting for you to answer just one of her prayers in a way that life itself cannot answer, leading to a sister so dogmatically aligned that her children have no hope but to become clones of her beliefs and naivete, leading to a constant view of the black sheep son that I am as searching through this world to find something as meaningful as you, and that eventually I will come back to you as the only constant I can rely on. I'm sorry to say this, God, but you have never been constant. I used to listen to you, and it never led to success. I used to read your words, and it never gave me hope or comfort. I used to pray to you in good times and in bad times, and always, always, the response was just the sound of the rushing of blood in my ears. I used to cry out to you to save me from the attacks of evil, and it always ended with me finally crying myself dry, pulling myself up, and deciding, God or no God, I'd have to make my own decisions and get on with living my life. I have to think for myself and stop thinking that you're going to intervene on my behalf. I have a life to live, and I only have one chance to live it. I can't and will not wait for you to make it a good or worthwhile life. Because if you are there, you aren't listening. And if you are listening, you don't care. And if you do actually care, you are quite the asshole in the way you show it. So, one last time. God, if you exist, and my logic, discretion, and intellect are wrong, please forgive me. I know that it will not save my soul if heaven and hell exist and nothing I learned as a child and young adult are true, but know that I do not make this decision lightly or without much thought and careful deliberation. Blind faith has done nothing for me, for my family, or for my friends, while on the other hand, logic, determination, hard work, and intelligence have begat us so much. To give you praise for our successes removes the wonder of our own ability, and it cheapens the value of our lives. No longer can I allow your judgment to rule over my life, because it is my life. Heaven be damned, the greatest gift life has to offer is being here, now, alive, and able to make of my life that which I deem important and worthy without simply waiting for the inevitable swipe of death's scythe to send me to the streets paved with gold and harps and rose gardens. God, if you exist, tell my children that I never met that I love them. And I wish that I could have met them someday, but that I also can't spend my waking moments of existence hoping that I will, hoping that the great reunion will happen. Maybe they won't understand, but I think that had we met, they might have. Tell my family that I didn't do this to spite them, or to hurt them, or to rebel against them, or you. Tell them that I loved them and hoped only that they would think for themselves after looking at me as an example. And hopefully I can be a good example and not pointed to as proof for their beliefs. Most of all, God, if you truly exist, please take care of my mother. She'll never understand why I have turned away from that which she taught. She'll always praise you and wait for your words no matter what her senses and logic tell her. She'll never forgive me if I ever tell her, and it will break her completely if I do. Seeing the way you have turned a deaf ear and a blind eye to her all these years, no matter how hard she studied, no matter how much she prayed, is proof enough to me to turn away from you. But I had hope. Hope that you would one day reveal yourself to her, one of your most ardent servants. Well, God, I'm done hoping that you might actually deign to manifest yourself in her life, and I instead hope that my mother will someday accept that you aren't there, aren't listening, and that she is able to do all things through her own abilities that strengthen her. I honestly don't think that she will ever give up on you, so you better have one hell of a nice heaven for her. She likes pastels and white. You better see to it. I think maybe Dad will understand, and I think maybe he now believes in you simply to ensure his eternity. He was always a good man and always will be. So if there's a caveat in your bullshit rules that don't allow him to join my mother in heaven, I swear to everything unholy and depraved that we will break out of hell and kneecap you. Anyway, God, I think I'm almost done here. Every day I'm finding new strength that you couldn't ever give me. I'm rediscovering that awe and wonder in the real world that I had as a child. I want to live when I wake up in the morning. I don't even want to sleep so that I can live some more before having to recharge. I have hope that my life will be something meaningful and something powerful and something beautiful. You never did that for me. You and your servants' teachings only made me hope for the end to come so I could fly around the galaxies and have a picnic in a stellar nursery. I didn't care about my one chance to live, but I do now, and you don't get the glory or the honor or the praise. I learned of prophecy, and here's one for you. Your words told me that I would reach this point one day. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I gave up childish ways. So I guess I'm done now, God. I'll not be back. And whenever I doubt that I made the right choice, I'll work through it and remember how much more existence is worth now that I have regained sovereignty over my life. Goodbye, God.